Hi guys, welcome to Mashup Monday. This is my first episode. So every Monday we'll be doing a new character mashup, and this is one from my new Simpsons Street Fighter series. I actually started this last year, but I'm redoing a couple of the characters because I wasn't entirely happy with them. So this will be a time lapse of what I did last night on the live draw. You can see that on Instagram and Facebook. So welcome to join every Monday. So for this particular piece, I'm using a Wacom Intuos Pro tablet, and I'm using that in Adobe Illustrator. Sometimes you use an iPad Pro. I always favor Illustrator for print work, mainly because you're working in a vector. There's no right or wrong, Photoshop's great. There's other programs as well. I just mainly use Photoshop for my digital work, whereas vector is more for print, but you've just got to find out what works for you. So you want to start by uploading your existing sketch. Then once that's in place on your canvas or your artboard, I'm using Adobe Illustrator, so what you want to do is lock that bottom layer. You can change the opacity, so that's making it a bit more transparent, and set up a new layer and start laying your lines over it. Cool, so now you've done your outline and you're happy with it, what you want to do is lock that layer so it's untouchable. Your original sketch, you can get rid of that, you could just make it invisible or delete it, whatever you want to do. And now you want to set up a new layer which is going to sit below your outline layer. That way it's not going to interfere or overlap what you've already drawn. So there's a few different methods you can do to colour in digital work. Personally, I like using the blob tool. It's a little bit longer, however I like that pen to paper feel. A lot of people use the live paint tool, which is a lot quicker, but it's just personal preference. You just have to find out what works for you and what feels good. At the end of the day, drawing is all about having fun, not about shifting work out as quickly as possible. Cool, so now your colouring is all done, it's time to add some shading and shadow. So what we're going to do is we're going to set up a new layer, and that layer is going to sit just over your base colour and just underneath your black outline, so that way it doesn't conflict with any work that you've done. Lock your other layers so you're not working within those, and it's already going to be set to this particular layer. Just imagine where the light source is coming from. So in this particular case, it's coming from the flame that's coming out of his mouth. On that side of his face, it's always going to be a bit lighter, and on the opposite side, it's going to be a bit darker as well. So have some fun, see how it goes, and you can always go back and edit it. If you want to flick off that layer, you can always hide it so you can see what your original artwork looks like. I'd always over-exaggerate your shadow as well, because on a smaller platform like a sticker or a digital image like on Instagram, it's going to be quite a small image. So always over-exaggerate the shadow if you can. It just makes it look a little bit more three-dimensional. Have some fun. Cool, so there you have it. You've done all your shading, and if you're happy with that, then you can call it a day. I put the old image next to the new one on the same artboard just so you guys can see the differences between them. Obviously the new one's got a bit more shadow going on with it. I think I prefer what we've done today, so I think I'll be sticking with that one. Don't forget to check me out on Instagram and Facebook. If you guys have got any questions, feel free to comment below. I'll get back to you as soon as possible. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll catch you next Monday.